local man is accused of 45 counts of horse abuse, and just days before his trial, he's speaking out in an interview you'll only see on KSNT News.
Firemen have come in and pulled horses out of the ponds. We lost one mare.
And this is video from a neighbor, and it shows the horses getting stuck in the mud as they were trying to get a drink. Prosecutors say the crimes took place on a farm in Hoyt. KSNT News reporter Dan Garrett has been investigating the case for months. He joins us live from the farm after talking to the person being charged. Dan?
Jace, Brooke, you can see the pond there. That's where dozens of horses went to drink water. Right now, it's a little iced over, and in the summer, it was often too muddy to drink from. Tonight, officers have removed the horses from the property, and the owner says he's in shock after he says he took great care of them. At one point, dozens of horses lived on Frank Johnson's farm. He was breeding them for racing, but he says over the course of 6 months, authorities took all of his horses away.
It makes me mad because these people that take them have admitted to me, oh, I don't know anything about horses.
Neighbors say Johnson left his horses in horrible conditions, without enough hay and water, and there was a lack of shelter.
They were starving. Like I said, they were eating the leaves off the trees. They went from, you know, nice, healthy-looking horses to skeletal within 6 months.
Brooke Green lives nearby and sent these pictures of the horses on Johnson's property and was one of several to call the sheriff.
When we got her, she was in pretty bad shape, and the neighbor took a picture of her, and that's what started it all.
I mean, I've got pictures of there's 20 or 30 horses standing on top of that pond, and they haven't had any water for 3 days.
Do you feel like you were lacking in the care at all?
No, not in the care, no. These horses were being very well taken care of.
While Johnson faces criminal charges of animal cruelty. Coming up tonight at KSNT News at 10, I'll explain where these horses were taken to, and I'll also explain why neighbors are all concerned that these horses could be sold for slaughter. Live in Hoyt, Dan Garrett, KSNT News.
Dan, thank you.